Hello, welcome to my series, The Wonderful World of Nutritional Plants. And today we will be talking about Orach. Orach is a mountain spinach with incredible properties. It's anti-cancer, it's an antioxidant, fights aging and degenerative processes in the body, protects the heart, and is an anti-inflammatory. It's been used throughout the ages and got its first mention in 77 after Christ. The reason we need more alternatives to our conventional vegetables is that we need to go back to high nutrient-dense vegetables, which this is. It has a lot more vitamins than normal spinach. For example, the vitamin C content is through the roof, and it doesn't taste as much of spinach as normal spinach does, so it is probably more palatable for children if they don't like spinach because it's too spinachy. Now, you can't buy this in the shops because it doesn't, as far as I know, it doesn't. It's not available yet. So what you need to do is you need to grow it in your garden. There are seeds you can buy. There are obviously various different varieties. There's a green variety and a red one, for example, but there are a lot of varieties of this plant. And just throw the seeds in your garden. The good thing is it is very hardy and it grows even in clay soils, and although it germinates in the cool, by the time summer comes along, it's established and it can survive the summer. It will also come back year after year, so once you've thrown it in your garden, you'll have it there for the next year and the year after. If that's not something you want, then you need to put it in a pot. And if you want to throw it in your local park, that's also an idea because you know where you've thrown it, and when it comes and grows, you'll be able to see it. Nobody else will pick it because they wouldn't know it. So if you don't have a garden, you can use guerrilla gardening techniques by just using a bit of land that is publicly available. There are a lot of varieties, and you can cook with it. The recipes are basically the same as you would be using spinach. And I'm going to show you now a little clip how I found it and how I foraged for
it. So today I'm going to show you borak, or mountain spinach. I found it foraging here. Obviously, a lot of different species and different types. So this is the mountain spinach that we are going to cook a little bit later. And as you can see, the leaves are organized in alternating fashion. So some leaves come out here on the right, some leaves come out of the left, the next one is on the left, the next one is on the right. And it has a little bit of a velvety, it's quite soft, has a little bit of a velvety sheen on top and little sort of a whitey velvety covering, but otherwise it's very smooth. And there's a little, what is it, snail, proving it's a very organic plant, and it's still very young here in Spain. At the moment it's March, so it's relatively small. They can get quite large, but obviously the younger they are, the tastier they will be. So this is the orach plant, or the mountain spinach, or Spanish spinach, and I found it here growing in a wildflower meadow for foraging and cooking with.
So I'm off to cook my Aurac vegetables now, and I hope you can get a hold of some seeds and give growing and cooking it a go. Let us know in the comments how you get on and what your thoughts are and what recipes you have used Aurac in. All right, take care, bye.